Hey guys, welcome to a video. I'm going to show you guys some stretches to do after a workout, after a walk. I personally just did a 30-minute weighted walk with 20 pounds. The walk felt really good, but I couldn't go walk all the way to 60 minutes in one go as of today. So I stopped at 30 minutes, felt good. I'm gonna take a break. I'm gonna make sure my muscles are refreshed the next time I go back out for the next half hour. And I'm going to be doing those weighted walks for about 3 to 4 times a week, with a day and a half or a day's rest. Doing those walks around 3 times a week with a day rest in between, at least to be able to recover properly from a tough or enduring workout. I want to show you guys some stretches that you can do for 60 seconds or however many seconds or however long you want. But me personally, I recommend at least stretching for a couple minutes after a workout to prevent yourself from getting injured. The first stretch I'm going to do is actually derived from a deadlift exercise. So the deadlift exercise is, I'll show right now. I'm taking care of something right here. The deadlift exercise is basically feet shoulder width apart. You're going to down like this. You're going to pull up like this. That's the deadlift exercise. So the stretch is to kind of derive from that same movement back. So I'm going to have my feet in a wide stance. In a wide stance. Or in a V shape that you're seeing right here. And what I'm actually going to do is, like, as I'm reaching down, you want to have your feet as comfortable as possible. You want to have them out in a V shape, but out as comfortable as you can without hurting yourself or causing any pain. You don't want to do any exercise through pain. That is disaster. So the first exercise is right here, grabbing your ankles. Make sure your feet are stationary, kind of flexing and those muscles and all those joints, ligaments that are in play. Tendons, flexing all of them, maintaining a position, and you're able to reach even further, and continue to reach even further. If you want to make the exercise easier, you can just move your wrist a little bit higher, control the movement. Come back up, hold that position, you're good. I recommend doing that for 60 seconds, which I'm going to show here. Also, you can do different feet stands and different grips as well. So, different grips could be even like this, low, high, or high, low. You kind of want to experiment with that. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10. Feels good. One, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's 30 seconds. You can also do this. Stretching one leg, kinda. You can do that. Okay. Kinda take a little breather. Don't work out or go through an exercise workout fatigue. That will hinder your form and technique, which in turn will hinder your consistency and how effective a rep or exercise can or can't be. So, going again, come to a position. A way I can tell if this is a comfortable position for me is if I can do any movement that's comfortable for me, my progression, my skill range, and if I can control the movement. So one, if I control it right now, it's comfortable. Now the goal, of course, is if you want to unlock more range of motion, it's to the same movement, unlocking that range of motion. So now I'm going backwards. One, two, three, four, five. Engage your upper body as well as you're tightly, or not tightly, but as you're grabbing your ankles. Engage the upper body. Make sure it's not just hanging. Okay, 40 seconds right there, 20 more seconds, and I'll show you guys something that you guys can do also to relieve some hamstring tightness, or it's hamstring and quad tightness, but it's specifically for hamstring. I'll show you guys that after I finish this last 20 seconds. I'm going to go a little bit wider, a little bit closer, narrow this time. But I'm going to make sure I can control this range of motion. Now we're going to go like this. And same thing. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. There you go, guys. 60 seconds. I recommend doing that. At least that one stretch. It's a really good stretch. Active stretch, static stretch. You can get progressions through active or static, which is a really, really good bonus, really good plus to have that available to you. The next one, you can do this for 30 seconds each leg and kind of be done with it. So this one is kind of like this, my feet shoulder width apart. I'm making sure from the toes, the soles of my feet to my shoulders and head, that my feet have total control of the ground, and my hands have total mobility in the air. So you kind of go like this, and then kind of bend your knees a little bit, but not too much, just a little bit to be, just bend your knees enough to feel the quads and the hamstrings kind of in the position where they tucked in. Then you go lean over your hips, or kind of lean over your thighs, and you want to, with one elbow, move it to one knee while the other one is kind of in front of that elbow or that knee. Hold it. One, two, three, four, five. It can be 5 seconds there. And same thing. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. That's 10 seconds. One, two, three, four, five. As you unlock that range of motion, you can just pull and squeeze harder with your muscles, controlling your movement. One, two, three, four, five. And again, with this movement, activate your upper body. Look. One, two, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. You can do that for 30 seconds each leg. And be really wound up, really loose, really ready to take on the world.